you're going to take a look at how to record a narration for your course using iSpring Suite. When you have your presentation open in PowerPoint and have the iSpring Suite tab selected, you will see your narration tools up here. With these options, you can record a voiceover for your course, add an instructor video, and under Manage Narration, you can get more powerful options to edit your recordings, import your audio, or record something new. Let's look at how to actually record some audio by selecting the Record Audio button. Before I even think about hitting that record button, I'm going to make sure that I have everything set up properly. By selecting options, I can make sure my microphone is set up correctly and it's good to go. It's always a good idea to have a script when you're going to record a narration. And with iSpring Suite, you can check the Show Slide Notes box, and if you have added any notes for your slides in PowerPoint, they will be automatically added into the text box. Or, if you want, you can paste the script there manually. If you want to only record one slide at a time, you can select this Process the Slide Only box. But I recommend recording your whole presentation in chunks. You can select your starting slide here with this drop-down menu. I always find it easiest to start recording from slide one. Now that I have everything set up, I'm going to go ahead and hit the record button. Welcome to this employee fast motor sales training. Once you have finished recording your slide, go ahead and select the next slide button. If you need a minute to get organized, you can select the pause button at any time. It is much easier to deal with a mistake if you are recording in smaller chunks. If I begin a recording and am not happy with it, I can just select pause, gather my thoughts, and try again. If the slide you are selecting already has narration, you will be prompted to override the current narration or stop recording. I am going to override. If your presentation contains animation, the next slide button will change to the next animation button, so that you can sync your narration to your animations as well. A great tip when you are recording is to leave a pause at the beginning. This gives you some breathing room to work with. You may not need it, but you can always cut it out later. But it's always a good idea to have it, just in case. I also recommend recording all of your narration at one time and with the same equipment for best results. Once you are done recording, hit the stop button. Now you can use the play button to preview your narration. If you are happy with your narration, then you can go ahead and select OK, and your narration will be added to your presentation. Once you have saved and closed in PowerPoint, your narration will no longer be visible. Just head to Manage Narration to play your voiceover back or edit it. If you want to find your audio files, go to the PowerPoint file. Here you will find a folder with the same name as your presentation file. In this folder, you will find all of the audio files you recorded. And that's how you record a successful narration for your course.